Everybody, it's your boy IFLOWZ of IFLOWZ ENT, and this is free artist development. So I'm about to give you free game. This first episode, I'm going to teach you how to get started in the music industry. I'm going to teach you how to get your copyrights. I'm going to show you how to register your name as an artist, as a band, or as a label. I'm going to show you how you can do song splits to get equal shares to each individual, and how to find PROs, performance rights organizations. Also, I have a sweet bonus. I'm gonna show you distribution. I'm gonna show you paid distribution. I'm gonna show you free distribution. So, first things first, let's say you, the individual, decided you wrote a song. One day you just wrote down some ideas and about a week later, it turned into a song, right? Now, I know what you're thinking. Okay, now I'm an artist. Now I'm a rapper, singer, or whatever the case may be. I done found myself. I done found my inspiration. I need to copy my. I need to copyright my stuff before somebody tries to steal this from me. So what do? You take it, you put it in the mail, and you mail it to yourself, right? Wrong. Let me tell you why that's not the appropriate thing to do. Rest in peace to the late, great Michael Jackson. But back when the song Butterflies came out, Michael Jackson is the reason that poor man copyrights no longer work. When the song Butterflies came out, there was a young artist in the studio that wrote the song. He wrote the song as Michael Jackson was passing through the studio. Michael heard the song. Michael wanted the song. Then Michael produced the song. Michael made millions off the song. The young gentleman found this song disturbing because he wrote it. He didn't own copyrights. What he did was he mailed those lyrics to himself. So when he went to court, the judge stood and asked the gentleman who wrote the song to sing the song. And then he asked Michael Jackson to sing the song. And then he asked the jury, who do you think made the song? Who sounds more relevant to the song, like the person that wrote the song? Of course, everyone chose Michael Jackson, but the moral sense of this was that the judge was trying to get the young man to understand there's no shortcuts in real life. Do it the right way the first time, and this wouldn't be a matter. This wouldn't be an issue of the matter. A gentleman could have walked away, solidified, known, paid off of Michael Jackson had he beat him, had he known how to beat him. But he stuck to his poor man's copyright, and he learned what happens to the poor man. So, forget all that. We're going to jump right into this. So, right here, I already got everything opened up for you, ready to go. So, first thing you want to do is go to copyright.gov, okay? Don't go anywhere else. I am telling you, it is such bullshit. Like, $100, $150, $80 for a copyright just for a song. Are you that foolish? Listen. I've known about this since high school because one of my social studies teacher was a jingle writer. He told me about this back in the ninth grade. He told me, back in 2000, he told me this was the first time I learned how to register songs. He said, all you have to do is go to the, he said, you go down to downtown DC, you go to Department of Registration, there's a copyright office. It's called the copyright office, but it's another specific name, something of registration. I can't think of it right now, but this is the official website. This is the U.S. government copyright website. So anything you register through here is official document. Now here's the trick to this. Whenever you upload something to be copywritten, from the minute that it's uploaded, it is protected. You, the individual, will not receive a certificate until 6 months later. Why? I don't know. Maybe because they have to do processing, filing, assigning, and updates worldwide to make it official, but the fact that it's on document makes it official. So if you wrote a song today and you copyrighted it today, and 1 month later, I heard your song and I stole it from you because you never put it out, but I went and copywrote the song and released the song, you could sue me. Why? Because you copywrote it first. You went to the official copyright.gov website. copyright.gov. And it's only $60, y'all. It used to be $35, but through current updates, I just got an update about 2 months ago. They said that they're finally updating the website price. It's always been $35 since the beginning, but now they're doing $60. Now, what this does, all you have to do is right here, go to register. You want to register a document and all of that. I'm not going to go through the process of trying to sign in and all of this stuff, but we'll see what this is right here. It's a video, so let's see what the video explains differently than me.
This application may be used to register a group of no more than 10 unpublished works created by the same author or co-authors. There is a limited exception for sound recordings and the works embodied in the recordings, allowing for registration of up to 20 works total. Please note, the Copyright Office offers a group registration option for unpublished photographs, which allows up to 750 photographs to be registered using one application and filing fee. For more information, please see the office's website. There are strict eligibility requirements that must be met in order to register a group of unpublished works. Before completing the application, you will be asked to confirm that you understand and meet all of these requirements. If the office determines that your works are not eligible for this option, it will refuse your registration. You may then choose to submit a separate application, deposit, and filing fee for each work.
Each time.
To submit an application for a group of unpublished works, first, log into your Echo account. Click Register a Group of Unpublished Works under the Copyright Registration heading on the left side of the home page.
Right there.
Review the information on the Registration Process Overview screen. If your works meet all of the eligibility requirements, click Start Registration to proceed. Otherwise, click the back button to return to the home screen and select the standard application.
Now let's pause this right there. What he's saying is, this is the first thing you have to do in a copyright. You have to pay. There's no filing, there's no upload, there's no registration until you pay. Once your $60 submission is submitted, you have the rest of your life to use that. So the smart thing to do is say this. You're an artist. You're about to drop a CD in 3 months, 6 months, next year, whatever. You copyright that material now. Please protect yourself. But let's say the music isn't done, okay? Your projection date is 12 months from now. You're about 4 songs in, and you're only trying to do 10 songs because these are new updates. It used to be unlimited uploads, photos, videos, audio, whatever, like, but things change. So they're getting picky now. So be smart about how you create your music, okay? Because this is your money you're spending. So let's say you spend the $60 today. You only have 4 songs recorded, mixed, and 1 song that's mastered. You want to do this copyright. You don't have to do it yet, okay? You've already paid your $60, right? Right. So you now have the time to finish the music. Because whenever you finish the music, you have the graphics, and you have everything you're gonna put to it, whether it's a video, all of that. Everything that goes attached to this music, you will upload together at one time. So it'll be copyrighted as a package. Get what I'm saying? So think about this. There's an artist that wants to put out a CD right now. They're halfway through the CD. They got $60 today. They know the CD won't be done for like another month and a half. But they pay that registration today. They pay that $60. And like he said, press the back button unless you're ready to start registration. So that person would just leave this website. Done, right? Right. Go finish your music, because we want to hear it. And when you're done with the music, come back to this website because you already paid for your slot. So now you can start registration.
Or one of the other registration options listed. Next, click the type of work drop-down and select the entry from the drop-down list that best describes the works you seek to register. As you click on the entries in the list, a description of the corresponding type of work will be provided. Please be sure to carefully review the eligibility requirements that are included with each description. All of the works must fit within the same category. If the works do not fit within the same category, you must prepare a separate application for each type of work. For example, musical compositions are considered works of the performing arts, and cartoons are considered works of the visual arts. If the author created 5 compositions and 5 cartoons, you should submit 1 application for the 5 compositions, selecting the option for work of the performing arts, and a separate application for the 5 cartoons, selecting the...
Are you getting this? Are you grasping this? Please let me know in the comments if you need a better explanation of what he's trying to say. Because what he's trying to say is exactly what I'm trying to say. And I really hope you're getting this because I need you to win, okay? I need you to succeed because your success rides on me. I ride on your success. If I can't make you successful, I can't make myself.
Option 4, work of the visual arts. As mentioned earlier, there is a limited exception for sound recordings and the works embodied in the recordings, allowing for registration of up to 20 works.
This is music CDs, okay? This is your audio. This is for all you music artists that use Spotify, Apple Music, iTunes, whatever, Deezer, Xbox, I don't care. It's a sound recording and you need this. Please pay attention.
To register sound recordings and their underlying works, you must select the option for sound recordings. After selecting the option that best describes the works you are registering, check the box confirming that you have read, understood, and meet all eligibility requirements for filling an application.
You do, and you know why you gonna check that box? Because you getting schooled with Flows, not by Flows, because the Flows promise is more solid than gold. You feel me? Let's go.
For a group of unpublished works. If all of the works do not meet these requirements, return to the home page to select a different application. To proceed with the application, click Continue at the top of the screen. On the Titles screen, click New to enter the title of one of the works you are registering. Enter one title only, then click the Save button to return to the previous screen.
This is the part where you save the name of your CD, not the name of the song. If it's a single and you're gonna release the single as the name, like my song or single, Liquor Store, is a single. So therefore, it is an individual album. It is a one-track album. So the album is called Liquor Store, and the single is called Liquor Store. So in this box, I put the title of the album, which is Liquor Store.
If you attempt to enter 2 or more titles, you will see a warning message reminding you that only one title may be entered. Repeat this process for each work you are registering. Do not enter more than 10 titles in the application.
Now, do you get that part? What he's saying, let me double back. Let me double back real quick because I know what I just told you. Okay? Now what he's saying, this is between the two. Okay, I'm going to explain it like this. When I told you about my song Liquor Store, I told you how to register a single, okay? Not all of you have singles. Some of you have compilations. Compilation is multiple tracks. An EP is 30 minutes or less in runtime. A LP is 30 minutes or longer in playtime. What does that mean? If you have an album less than 30 minutes, it's an EP. So you're gonna register each song individually by name. Not the title of the album, okay? Not right here. Not the title of the album. Here you're gonna put each individual song for that one CD. So if you got a CD with five songs on it, you're gonna register each name right here in this part. I'm tripping. Right there in that box. And this is what it will look like.
If you provide more than 10 titles, you will not be able to advance the application and will need to delete the extra titles to proceed. After entering titles for each of the works you are registering, click Continue. On the completion screen, enter the year in which the works were completed. If the works were completed in the same year, enter that year in the space provided. If the works were completed over a period of 2 or more years, provide the year of completion for the most recent work in the group.
You got that? So not your oldest song. Like, I have an EP out right now called I Rap EP. I-R-A-P by IFLOWZ. Look it up on YouTube. I Rap. Okay, I Rap is what it's called. Now, I got 5 songs on there. I completed this in 2019, even though I've been recording it since 2010. But the last song that was recorded on there was Liquor Store. It was released in 2017 and remastered and re-released on the EP in 2019. Or was it 2020? It was 2019. But yeah, let's get back to this work.
Continue to save this information. On the author's claimants screen, you will give information about the author of the works being registered. Each person or organization named must be an author or co-author and the claimant or co-claimant for every work in the group. If you are the author of all the works, you may click Add Me to enter your information. If you were completing the application on behalf of the author, click New.
Now, what is he talking about? Somebody else doing my copyrights? Like, really? Yes. Because you know who handles your paperwork whenever you're an artist and you have a partnership with somebody? Your manager, your record label, whoever is in your circle, your mom, your sister, your brother, your girlfriend, whoever you assign to do this. Okay? Now, you can mask it and have them act like you and type it all in. But this is how they are known that they did their job. They go on contract with you. Normally a manager does this with you. A manager takes your music from the studio and registers it for you. But what I'm teaching you is how to do this for yourself. So you know what you're giving to a manager. What power are you giving away? You get what I'm getting at? All right. So here, let's say you want me to copyright your music. I'll do it, and I can charge you for it. There's people that charge a fee to do copyright work. I might charge, like I told you, you go to those websites that cost $100 to do a copyright. They're doing this right here, bro. Like, where is it? They're doing this right here. I'm trying to point. It's inverted. They're doing this. But it's a website that's masked that tells you it's so much more because they're charging you a third-party vendor fee. They're charging you a service fee. Cut out the middleman. That's what this is about. Flows ain't the middleman. He killing the middleman. You feel me?
To the author's name and address in the spaces provided. Select the best description of the works the author created from the author created drop-down list. After entering all the required information, click Save. If the works were created by 2 or more co-authors, click New to enter this same information for the other authors.
Now, this may be an episode all in itself because I'm starting to see where this is going. I know where your mind is going. So Flows, he talking about ownership on a song, but I got features on a song. It's like me and 6 other people on a song. Okay, calm down. Please, calm down. Pay attention. Because this is how you register that. Each person that writes or composes any part of the song goes on this document. If I made the beat, I get a percentage because I made that beat. That's my creation. If you wrote the lyrics, yo, I'm the MC, oh, you get a percentage. You're part owner. Let's say I wrote the lyrics for you, but you're the singer. I get a percentage for what I wrote. You get a percentage for what you sung. You see, because your voice is an instrument and that belongs to you, so you're entitled to your share. The lyrics came from my idea, so I'm entitled to my share. And the producer that created the beat is due to his share. I hope this is all making sense. Everybody needs to go on a copyright. If any part of your song shares anybody, they need to get on this document, because this will protect you in the long run. This will protect them in the long run. No one can get sued because everybody is legitimately equally yoked.
Note, the authorship statement should describe each and every work that the author created. If the works were created by two or more authors, the authorship statement for each author must be exactly the same. If the authorship statement is not the same for each author, you will not be able to advance the application and will need to edit the author information to proceed. After entering information for all authors and claimants, click Continue. If the works being registered contain material that has been previously published, is in the public domain, or has been previously registered with the Copyright Office, briefly describe this pre-existing material in the material excluded space on the
Now that's pretty self-explanatory.
Limitation of claim screen. For previously registered material, enter the registration number and year of registration in the spaces provided. If the Copyright Office issued multiple registrations for the pre-existing material, give the number and year for the most recent registration.
So what he's saying is, you can update a copyright, okay? Now let's say I owe somebody some money. And the only way I make money is through my royalties. Or let's just say I want to sell the right, forget all that. Let's say I want to sell my song, Liquor Store, right? I already have this information on file. So if I wanted to sell my song to you, for you to make royalties, let's say you don't change anything. You just want ownership of the song so you can collect money from it now because it's a hit. It's a, you know what I'm saying, top seller. Just hypothetically saying. Now, I can transfer ownership to you, and this is how you do that. Or let's say there's a remix. Everything's the same, but we just extended the song. This is how we update that and add you to it, okay? This is how you would update your copyright for any reasons you needed to update it.
These works do not contain any pre-existing material. Please leave all spaces on this screen blank. In either case, click Continue to proceed. On the Rights and Permissions screen, you may identify the person who should be contacted regarding copyright management information or permission
to use
these works.
This would be your publisher, your manager, or whoever is responsible for releasing your content.
And may be viewed by visitors to the
office's website. Even if it's you.
Do not complete the Rights and Permissions screen unless you want this contact information to be included in the office's online record. On the Correspondence screen, give information for the individual the Copyright Office should contact to answer questions that may arise during the examination of your claim. On the Mail Certificate screen, enter the address where the registration certificate should be mailed. Special handling is an expedited service that requires a significant surcharge fee. It is granted only if a registration is needed on an expedited basis for pending or prospective litigation, customs matters, or contract or publishing deadlines.
Are you picking this up?
Do not complete this screen unless you qualify for and intend to pay for expedited service.
Are you getting this?
The application must be certified by the author or one of the co-authors of these works, by the owner of exclusive rights in these works, or by an authorized agent of one of these parties. Check the box that describes the person who will certify the application and enter that person's name as the certifying individual. Click Continue to review the information provided in the application. Carefully review the information you entered before proceeding further. Use the links in the navigation bar to go back and make corrections if needed. Click Add to Cart to pay the fee and submit your application. After payment is submitted, you will receive an email confirming the receipt of your application and payment. To complete the submission process, you must upload an electronic copy of all the works being registered in this group. Click Continue to proceed. The application you just submitted will be displayed on a new screen. Before you upload electronic copies, consult the list of file types that will be accepted by the system. To upload files, click the green Select a File for Upload button. A new window will open, allowing you to select one or more files from your computer. Select files to be uploaded and click Open. In general, each work should be uploaded as one digital file. Only in limited cases will you need to upload multiple files for each work, such as when you are registering a group of jewelry designs and you need to upload multiple images to show the front and back of each piece. Mm-hmm. The files you selected will be displayed with the corresponding application. Be sure you've selected files for all the works being registered in this group. Click the blue Start Upload button to upload your files. A progress bar next to each file will allow you to watch the upload process. As the upload is completed for each file, Successfully Uploaded will be added in front of the file name. Do not leave this screen or close the application before upload is complete for all files, as this will stop the upload process. Once upload has been completed for all the files you selected, click the Complete Your Submission button to confirm that no more files will be uploaded. You will receive an email from the Copyright Office confirming receipt of your files. You must upload a digital copy of your works. Do not print a shipping slip and mail a physical copy of the works. This completes all steps for submitting your application for a group of unpublished works.
And guys, that's it. That is how you register your music with the Copyright Office. So we'll end this first video right there. Thanks for watching. IFLOWZ ENT. This is Free Artist Development. You just learned how to do your own copyrights.
Confirming the receipt of your application, a new window will open, allowing you to select one or more to watch the upload process. As the upload is completed for each file, Successfully Uploaded will be added in front of the file name. Do not leave this screen or close the application before upload is complete for all.